Hello all, welcome to my channel SPS physics classes.
Now the next session regarding vectors level 2 model problems. The first question is that if four forces acts at a point O as shown in the figure and O is in equilibrium, very important thing, then the values of theta and P are how much they are asking. Let us analyze this particular figure. In this particular figure, this is origin, 10 newtons, 10 newtons, 10 root 2 newtons and P newtons of different four forces are acting at O and P makes an angle theta with the vertical. We have to find out the value of angle and as well as P. To find this particular one, let us try to make some resolutions along respect to axis. This is called y-axis. And this is x-axis. Now in this particular case, upon resoluting the value of P, here we have first one is P cos theta, here we have P sin theta. Okay, these are the two vectors we have from this particular case. Now, upon resoluting the value of 10 root 2 newtons, here we have 10 root 2 cos 45 and along in this direction 10 root 2 sin 45 degrees. Now, at this particular case, upon equating along x-axis and y-axis, first of all, we will try to analyze along x-direction. In the along x direction we have P sin theta must be is equal to cos 45 root 2 gets cancelled. We have 10 plus 10 is equal to 20. Along y direction we have 10 plus P cos theta must be is equal to sin 45 and root 2 gets cancelled. This value is equal to again 10. Therefore, P cos theta is equal to 0. That means cos theta should be equal to 0. Why? Because P cannot be 0. It is a non-zero vector. Therefore, P cannot be 0. That means cos theta is 0. So, cos theta is 0. This is possible at only theta is equal to 90 degrees. Substitute this value in this particular expression. Now, the final answer, that is P is equal to 20 newtons. And theta is equal to, we have 90 degrees. So, these are the answers what we have to remember for this particular case. Next, interesting question. In the given problem, modulus of A1 is 2 and modulus of A2 is 3. Magnitudes are given to vectors. And summation of their vectors, vectorial sum, not direct sum, not magnitude sum. So, vectorial sum given by 3. We need to find out value of some mathematical equation. We will try to explore this one. Let us see the solution. What is this particular term? Let us try to analysis. So, resultant is equal to 3 given. That means 3 is equal to a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos theta. That is the result for this particular case. So this is upon squaring on both sides, we got this result. Anyways, so this value is equal to 9 is equal to a1 square means 4, a2 square means 9 plus 2 into 3 into cos theta. In this particular case, 9 gets cancelled. Now minus 4 is equal to 4 into 3 into cos theta. Or the value of cos theta is equal to minus 1 by 3. This is the first result we have to be take care of this particular question. This is called step 1. Now come to the step 2. In the step 2, what is the expression given here? A1 plus 2A2 dot 3A1 minus 4A2. So all these are all the vectors. Now we have to take the dot product. That means a1 bar dot 3a1 bar. That means 3a1 square. Now a1 bar dot here. That means minus 4a1 bar dot a2 bar plus 6a1 bar dot a2 bar minus 4 to 8. 8a2 square we can write down here. 3 into a1 square means what? 4 minus 4. 4 and here it is goes with it. Plus 2 a1 bar dot a2 bar minus 8 into a2 square. A2 square means what we write down here? 9. So upon solving this, 12 minus 72. This result. Now plus 2 into a1 bar dot a2 bar. a1 bar dot a2, a1, a2 cos theta is a dot product. So a1 value is how much? 2 we got. And a2 value how much we got? a2 value 3 already given. And cosine angle between them is minus 1 by 3. So 3, 3 gets cancelled. We have plus 2 and minus 1. So here we have 2 to 4 and minus 1. So therefore, 12 minus 72 minus 4, that means here minus 60 minus 4, this value is equal to minus 64. This is the right answer for this particular case. So whenever an examiner given to confuse you, just try to analyze, okay, what they are given in the problem. Basing on that, we have to find out this particular result. Okay, now let us go to the next case. Now one of the interesting question, that is, the angle of inclination between two vectors P bar and Q bar is theta. If P bar and Q bar are interchanged their positions, then show that the resultant will be turned to an angle pi radians or pi degrees, where tan pi by 2 will be equal to P minus Q by P plus Q of tan theta by 2. So this is the thing what we need to be prove. This is simple like a proof. In the examination they will give you this entire quotient as alpha. Tan pi by 2 is equal to alpha into tan theta by 2. Then the value of alpha is how much they will ask. So to find out this particular result, we will try to analyze first of all a simple parallelogram law. Here goes with the solution. Now let us consider this is the first vector and this is the second vector. These two vectors are initially separated by an angle of theta degrees already mentioned in the problem. So therefore the angle between vectors is theta degrees already given in the problem. So this is the first vector P and this is second vector Q already given. Now this is the resultant of these two vectors. So we are just plotting the resultant vector. This is the resultant vector R bar. Now at this particular case, the R makes an angle of first of all alpha degrees here and beta degrees with this particular condition. Already we know this one. From this particular case, if you try to interchange the value of P and Q, R value shift towards the P because you are measuring angle alpha. So the deviation from original to present position. So this by upon interchanging, we have this imaginary vector, this is R. Magnitude never change direction. So the gap will be equal to pi. That's the logic given in the problem. So in this particular case, beta minus alpha, that value difference in angles is equal to pi already given, and beta plus alpha is equal to theta already we know these two logics. By using these two logics, we have the value of beta is equal to pi plus theta by 2 and alpha is equal to theta minus pi by 2. So we have, these are the two important logics. Now let us see by applying Lami's theorem. How to apply Lami's theorem in the problem? This is the first vector, second vector, and this is called R vector. That is called resultant vector P and Q. Let us imagine. So by upon preparing this entire result R, this is R actually, this is R prime stick. Now this angle corresponds to 180 minus alpha, and this angle corresponds to 180 minus beta, because this is beta and this is alpha. Already we know about these two things. By applying Lami's theorem here, what we write down? P by sine 180 minus beta, which is equal to Q by sine 180 minus alpha, we can write down. Upon solving this, we have P by sine beta is equal to Q by sine alpha. So we got result up to here. Now next step, what we have to do? So I'm just doing a small modification here. This final result is very important. Okay, now we got the final result here. Now so after this particular result, how to proceed, how to approach? Now let us try to consider P by Q. So P by Q is equal to, we have the value of sine beta by sine alpha. So P by Q is equal to sine of, what is the value of beta? So what is the value of beta? You got pi plus theta by 2 divided by sine, what we write down here, theta minus pi by 2. You can take upon exchange also possible here. Okay, now here P by Q is equal to, see here we have a plus b formula, sine a plus b formula we have to use. Upon solving this particular case and doing component and dividendo, or otherwise you better option is that try to take component and dividendo here only. Okay, what we got it is P plus Q by P minus Q, this value is equal to, so sine a plus b plus sine a minus b is equal to 2 sine a cos a by, so we will get this kind of result like this. So sine of, let us try to expand, theta by 2 plus pi by 2 plus sine of theta minus pi by 2 divided by sine of theta by 2 plus beta by 2 minus sine of theta by 2 minus pi by 2. So we got this particular result. Upon expanding this particular case, sine a plus b and sine of a minus b, here we have sine a plus b means sine a cos b, second term can be eliminated, therefore 2 sine theta by 2 cos pi by 2 by remaining term 2 cos theta by 2 by sine pi by 2. 2 gets cancelled. Upon solving this, we have the answer is sine by cos means tan, therefore tan theta by 2 divided by tan pi by 2. Upon cross multiplication, we will get the same answer as per the given condition. Now let us try to consider the next case. One of the interesting question which will helpful for you in the next coming sessions, that is, there is something like a coil which was given in the coordinate system x, y and z such a way that coil contains the dimensions of x cross y given as per the figure. Question is that we have to find out the value of area. The only physical quantity which having both vector and scalar nature is nothing but area. Sometimes area can be treated as scalar physical quantity. Sometimes it is necessary to deal this particular area as a vector quantity. The depending on the type of parameter we are choosing. Anyways, in magnetic moment calculations, we have to consider the value of A as vector quantity. In this particular question, to find out the value of area, so we will try to consider the direction of current first. In the direction of current only, you have to do the cross product. So along in this direction, so this is called A point, this is O, and this is B. Now to calculate this particular area, we have AO bar cross OB bar. This will give you the required area of the system. Now how to find out AO bar? How to find out this AO bar vector? To find out AO bar vector, this coordinate will be x, gamma 0, and this coordinate will be 0, comma 0. Therefore, what we write down it is simply final minus initial, therefore 0 minus x of I cap, remaining j and y coordinates are 0, therefore minus xi is the AO bar. And what is OB bar vector? OB bar vector is given by, what is the final position here? 0 comma y comma 0, here 0 x comma 0 comma 0. Anyways, here final minus initial we need. So final means here 0 minus 0 0 y minus 0, so therefore y minus 0 of j, that means we have here yj vector. Let us try to write down this particular value here. AO bar means minus xi cross, here yj we can write down. This value is equal to minus xy, so magnitudically just try to do the product including the sign convention here, just bring out all constants. Here I cross j, what is the value of I cross j? This I cross j value is equal to k cap, therefore aerial vector value will be equal to minus xy k cap, that means x into y into minus k cap square units. So
please subscribe my channel for further updates. Thank you and Jai Hind.